Well, good morning, everybody. It's Lisa Copeland, 15 Minutes of Fierce. And look at everybody jumping on this morning. Janelle and James and Anthony and Faye and Laura and Michelle. Happy, happy New Year's Eve. God, can y'all believe we're here? We are here. Today is the last day of 2018. And what I love about the last day of anything means you get to put a close to it, right? And 2018 for me personally was a great year. But 2019 is lining up to be so much better. And that's what I want for all of you. So we're going to talk a little bit about that today. Good morning, Chris Walsh. How are you? Faye, how are you? Lindsay, good morning. And, there's just so many possibilities. Like, I've been up since like 4:30 this morning. And I've been up because I'm excited. I've got some stuff I've got to do today. I'm working. Me and my team, we're working all day today. We've got so much going on in January that we need to get stuff out today. So Dina, good morning. And I'd love to hear what your guys' New Year's Eve plans are. Go ahead and just let us know what you're going to do over the new year. But I want to just tell you to be really, really careful. Well, why don't I take you back to Friday to JT McCormick? Was that not amazing? Seriously. I love bringing on people like him and John Hamlin and some of the people I know that have just been to hell and back to get to where they are today, you know? And I do it because I want to encourage you. I've got a really cool guest coming on Friday, Tom Ramsey. Same kind of story, friend of mine here in town. I just can't even make these stories up. I don't think I've got a story that good. James, how are you? Anthony, he says, let's make it happen in 2019, tribe. Yeah, you know, there's a lot of opportunity in 2019. And, you know, and so I'm going to go over some of the things I think that you need to do as you set your New Year's resolutions. As tonight, when it ticks midnight, what are you going to say to yourself? Because remember, if you don't have a plan moving forward, you're going to start tomorrow and it's just going to be another day. Hopefully you won't be so hungover that it's just another day, right? Zelinda, good morning. Dina's saying good morning to Anthony. So I went through six things. I wrote them down. That's why I keep looking down. I went through six things that I think make a really strong New Year's resolution. Now, if you've got other people out there that need to make New Year's resolutions, I want to challenge you to share this morning. I want you to say, it's time to decide on your resolution. Share it out to your tribe. Share it out to your groups. And because we're going to talk about what does it take? What is a strong New Year's resolution? You know, so many of us go out there and you're like, okay, I'm going to make $1 million. I'm going to lose 50 pounds. I mean, it's not realistic. It might be realistic to make $1 million. I will not take that away from you. But, you know, but you have to make it where it is consumable to you and to those around you. Otherwise, it just becomes another meme on Facebook. And I'm really, really ate up with that right now. Good morning, Megan. How are you, my friend? Sandy, James. James has already shared it. James, you rock. So put it out there to anybody out there in your tribe or your people that you know that they're working this morning on New Year's resolutions. And I'm going to tell you, ladies and gentlemen, the one thing, because it's the same crowd on here. Max, good morning to you. It's the same crowd on here every morning. And that is so impressive. Because the first thing I'm going to say about New Year's resolutions, and you guys hear me say it all the time, but when I go and I speak and I consult for companies, and people say, oh, Lisa, you know, I want to do more. I want to maximize my time. I'm like, then get up earlier in the morning. Start with earlier mornings. That maximizes your day. It also helps you go to sleep earlier at night. See, I used to be in this crazy vicious cycle. I would get up about 6:30, 7 o'clock over the last couple of years. And then I'm wide awake until 11 or 12 o'clock at night. Well, yeah, I don't need to be awake. I need to be like ready to put my head on a pillow by 9:30 or 10 o'clock at night so that I can get up earlier. And I cannot tell you how much more productive I am at 5 o'clock in the morning than I am at 5 o'clock in the afternoon. It just, I mean, my brain is on. I don't have the distractions. And I want to encourage all of you to do that. Because there is something. Hey, Michelle, how are you? Aiden, good morning, my dear. Happy New Year. Sandy, how are you, my friend? Janelle, good morning. But, you know, you'll be so much more productive from 5 to 7 a.m. You just will. And then if you want to go exercise, do it like at 7 a.m. Because I can tell you that my mind is on. I get my coffee. You know, I do all of that from 5 to 7. Do my show, of course, show prep, a little bit of that. But that's when I get through my emails. That's when I send, I've got two assistants. That's when I send notes out to both of my assistants. Hey, let's do this, this, and this. Let's think about this, this, and this. Let's get these people billed. Like billing people, won't lie. And all of that good stuff. So what is it that you're going to be? Janelle says, let's all be crazy fierce in 2019. And for those of you that are tuning in, what is fierce? Fierce is F, is to fear less, right? It's to take those chances that you, that you wouldn't have taken in 2018 or maybe even 2017. I is to use, is to have imagination. You've got to imagine the possibilities. How can you go out and crush it if you don't even know what you're going for? If you can't imagine the possibilities, you have got to be able to see yourself as wildly successful. I want you to be able to visualize, imagine all the possibilities that I know are available for you. E is you've got to be enthusiastic. You've got to believe to your soul that what you're doing is right, and you've got to love what you do. R is to be relentless, because nothing worth having is easy. You've got to jump in, and you've got to, you have to keep going, and you have to keep going, and you have to keep going. You can't just try it once. You can't just take one no. You've got to be relentless. You know, I think about some of the big business proposals that we put together, that my team and I put together in 2018. One of them is with a Fortune 1 company, you know, and it almost blew apart. It almost blew apart. I had a bad vendor. I had a bad partner on the deal. It was just, it was a bad deal. And with that relentless state of mind, knowing that this company needed what we had to offer, I went and I found another vendor. I found another partner on the deal. Okay. Now the deal's clicking along. So, you know, it's being relentless, because there are times in life and in business, just because the original plan doesn't work, like this big one that I did in 2018, but you can't be afraid to pivot. You cannot be afraid to pivot. I was able to tell that Fortune 1 company, hey, I had a bad partner on this deal. They couldn't deliver, but now I've got this partner and they can deliver. And oh, by the way, they're a Fortune 50 company who is my partner on the deal. Okay? So don't be afraid to pivot. And so to me, that is what relentless means. It's pushing as hard as you can push, but if it's not breaking through the sound barrier, if it's not breaking through getting the deal done, then don't be afraid to pivot. Don't be afraid to fire one partner and pick up a new partner if you fundamentally believe that this is what you're supposed to be doing. C and fierce is to crush approval addiction. You know, you can't worry about what the other people say. You can't worry about what the competitors say. I think Cardone says it best. Haters are fuel. You know, I mean, that is one guy that's out there that can absolutely, he just doesn't care what other people say. In fact, when I saw his Christmas message on Twitter, I just laughed, because I do know Grant. And he says, hey, Merry Christmas to, you know, my friends, my fans, my haters, and the trollers. I thought, oh God, I would love to write all that. For me, I'm just afraid it would attract more of them. But, you know, hey, you know what? He dances in his own space. So I will give Grant that. And so crush approval addiction. As long as you're doing what you know you're supposed to do, when you're working within your superpower, then don't worry about what other people think, because haters are going to hate. And the E in fierce is to execute. You know, you can be fearless. You can have imagination. You can have enthusiasm. You can be relentless. You can crush approval addiction. But if you don't get off the couch, if you don't execute, if you don't play to win every single day, we're going to be at the end of 2019. You're going to be like, damn, I missed another year. Christopher, good morning. Mabel, hello, gorgeous. Anyways, so I want to hear what some of your New Year's resolutions are. Come on. So here are the 6 steps that I say that you need to put into place to create your New Year's resolutions. Number one, you've got to keep it simple. Okay. What is the simple, you know, do you want to make more money? Do you want to be more healthy? Do you want to have better relationships? Do you want to get a new job? Do you want to move? Do you want to buy a house? Do you want to finish your education? I don't know. It's your resolution, but keep it simple. Don't make it so complex that on January 2nd, you look at it and you go, oh, I'm overwhelmed. Because we can all get overwhelmed. It's happened to me before. Absolutely. Anthony, thank you for putting it out there, my friend. Number 2, choose carefully. Because it's going to be super hard to become a gazillionaire, lose 100 pounds, find the perfect mate. I mean, come on. Focus. What is the one thing, right? That's one of the best books I've ever read, The One Thing. But what is the one thing that you want to concentrate on in Q1 for your New Year's resolutions? What is it? Is it to be more successful? Is it to be more healthy? Is it to get up earlier in the morning? I mean, come on, think about it. And then, of course, I want you to be realistic about your goals, which we just talked about, okay? Be realistic. Hey, James says, my own logo, more and more fleet business. Good, good. I want you to create bite-sized portions, meaning, let's just say you want to lose 50 pounds. Well, 50 pounds is, that's a lot of weight, and that's really good. But maybe you put the goal out there that in the first 90 days, you lose 10 pounds. Or in 45 days, you lose 10 pounds. And how are you going to do that? Well, you're going to have to exercise more. You're going to have to drink more water. You're going to have to eat better. See, with all those goals become there's other things you have to do to hit the big goal. All right. So don't put something so audacious out there that on January 15th, you look up and you're like, I quit. I failed. All right. So create it in bite-sized portions. See my notes right here? This is what I keep looking down at. Plan a time frame. All right. So if you want to lose 50 pounds, and I'm just pulling that out, right? You want to lose 50 pounds. You say, okay, I'm going to give myself 6 months to do that. Or I'm going to give myself 8 months to do that. All right. So that you don't look up on January 15th and you're like, I failed. So instead of, maybe you say, make a calendar on January 30th, you've lost 8 pounds. By February 28th, you've lost another 8 pounds. And you do it like that. And so those are bite-sized goals that you can track and measure every single month so that you don't get discouraged. And let's say in January, you only lose 7 pounds. Well, that means you need to lose 9 pounds in February and you need to figure it out. Okay. I live and die, y'all, by spreadsheets. Live and die by them. I'm telling you, it's actually Google Sheets. And if you guys are not on Google Office, you need to be. It is amazing. And I live and die by spreadsheets on everything. Everything I do, whether it's my business or my personal life or my finances or my health goals, it's all on a spreadsheet. So because the best goals, the best things that you can do, they have to be measurable. You know, in business, success and ROI has got to be measurable. Because if you can't measure it, you can't scale it. So how do you measure it? You go back to, let's see, what number was that for me? It was number 4. It is creating bite-sized portions. So whatever that goal is, I want to see you break it down month by month. Okay. And then from the month by month, I want you to break it down week by week. What is it going to take for you to do it? All right. Like I said, I've got them both personally, business-wise, and financially, actually 3 ways. All right. And JT McCormick talked about that. You know, people will spend all weekend on a Netflix marathon, right? Or binge watching, but you don't spend that kind of time on yourself, on your finances, on your business. So I'm going to encourage you to give up one of those binge weekends and binge on yourself, binge on your business, binge on your life, binge on your health, binge on your finances. Then you will crush it in 2019. I promise you. Janelle says, yeah, bite-sized portions. That's right. Michelle says, take small actionable steps. Danelle Delgado taught me that. Danelle Delgado taught me that. And that is the best advice I've ever been given. Absolutely. I agree 1,000,000%. Number 5 is, for me, is you have to plan a time frame. You know, what is the time frame that you want to hit that goal? Back to my 50-pound analogy. What is the time frame that you want to lose the 50 pounds? How are you going to put the actionable steps in? And then last but not least is you don't give up. Okay. Remember I told you the story in the beginning about the big contract I had with the Fortune 1. I have with the Fortune 1 company. I had to pivot. Okay. But I didn't give up. I don't want you guys to give up. You know, if for some reason what you're doing doesn't work, do it different. I love the word pivot. But R is for relentless and fierce. You've got to be relentless. Don't be afraid to pivot. But I'm going to tell you, the best advice I ever got probably 20 years ago is pivot quickly. When you see something's not working, don't beat a dead horse. I will pivot on something really, really quickly if it's not working. If a vendor I'm working with, it doesn't work, or a partnership I'm on doesn't work, or a strategy I'm using, I'm not seeing the ROI. I will pivot in a hot minute. Okay. You know, this do it till you die mentality. I don't buy it. I don't buy it at all. Okay. Those that can pivot quickly and efficiently are the ones who win the race. I promise you. Strategy is meant to be pivoted. Strategy is meant to be a working thing at all times. Okay. So anyways, it is 15 minutes of fierce. My 15 minutes is up, but can I tell every single one of you, and I mean this from the bottom of my heart, it has been amazing doing the last 90 days with all of you and getting to know all of you and the fact that you show up every single morning. I'm so blessed, and I mean that. And I, from the bottom of my heart, I wish every single one of you an amazing 2019. But here's the best part. We're going to do it together. We're going to do 2019 together. So it isn't like this is goodbye. Tomorrow, I'm not doing the show. I'm not being fierce tomorrow morning. I know better. So yeah, with New Year's Eve and all that good stuff. So I'm going to let all of you sleep in, celebrate the new year. But again, we will start Wednesday morning. I've got a business spotlight that I'm excited about. Friday, I've got Tom Ramsey on the show that I'm very excited about. Another great story of overcoming the odds. So anyways, 90-day goals. I'm going to post my six. Keep it simple. Choose carefully. Be realistic. Create bite-sized portions. Create a time frame. And don't give up. Those are my six. Anthony, can you write those that quickly? Anyways, I love you guys. Every one of you, be safe out there tonight. This is amateur night. Don't drink and drive. Take Uber. Take care of you. Be on the offense tonight. New Year's Eve terrifies me. It is totally amateur night. And I will see every one of you Wednesday. And I love you guys. And again, I'm so grateful that we're going to do 2019 together. Bye-bye.